My core belief is that you have to build leaders, and life is a mission. It is not just a career. You have to live your purpose and values. You have to build a legacy for yourself. There are many people who have got bulky resumes. They have acquired huge amount of wealth, money, luxuries, and they say they have built careers. But some of them end up in Tihar jail. You are hearing it every day in the news. Choose your legacy well. Build a legacy that people will be proud of you. And how do you do it? In army or armed forces, we are taught to operate from the firm base. We do everything from a secure space. This red circle where I stand today is today my firm base. I speak from here. Now, in life, time is always at a premium, including for me. My time is clicking. So, you have to take the basic mool mantra, the basic principle of life, which to my perception is, be fit, be ready. You have to be physically healthy, mentally agile, and emotionally in control of yourself. And you have to be equipped with relevant skills. Then you are on the firm base, ready to take on the world. I started my journey from the backwaters of India, in Bharat, in a small, overgrown kind of a village called as Nadbhai in Bharatpur district. I was studying in a Hindi medium school. And at the raw age of 10 years, in 1966, driven by euphoria of Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, after 1965 war, I chose to go to a Sainik school in Chittor. And since then, from 1966 till 2016, for 50 long years, I donned uniform, served with distinction, let me say, in all humility, please, and rose to the second highest rank of army commander. If I could do it, if I could do it, the question that I address to you is, why can't you? You all sit in an elite institution, in a great environment, build a legacy for yourself. And when you do that, you have to define your mission statement. You have to be brave enough to pen them down. Most of us hesitate to write it. Key it in on your computer and think of the end state. There is this principle, begin with the end in life. You have to always think consequences of your steps. And I must give you a mandatory caution. Guard against Musharraf folly, what I call as Musharraf folly, intruding into Kargil and getting kicked out. What is the point? You have to do something which makes you stay there and not get kicked out from there. You must have very smart goals. Goals which are specific, measurable, assignable in a team, realistic. You can't say, I will lose some weight. I lose it over a period of time. It can't be fuzzy. And it has to be related to time. Now, when you make your mission statement, you periodically need to validate it. You need to review it. And in order to review it, you need some buddies and some mentors. Now, today, buddy has become a jargon. Everybody says, I am your buddy. But who is really a buddy? The real buddies are in army, in patrols. There are two scouts which lead a patrol. Scout number one goes forward. Scout number two anchors him, covers all the dangers. He watches, he keeps the guard, and he is anchor. Now, in one such foray, scout number one got hit and fell. The leader who's immediately behind, he shouted. He told the scout number two, there is heavy fire. Scout number one is hurt. Don't go forward. Take cover. But mindless of this command, scout number two rushed forward to scout number one, picked up his lifeless body and brought it back. Now the leader chided him. What was the point? Why did you defy me? Why did you go forward? You know what the scout number two said? When I reached there, he was alive. He died in my arms and he told me, I knew you will come. Thank you, buddy. That is what being a buddy is. Build such relationships and then you need mentors. Mentors who set your life compass, who give you the values, who check you periodically and chide you. My first mentor, Risaldar Sakat Singh, like his name, was Sakat, hard, tough. He wouldn't allow you to stray anywhere. So as a youngster, we were assigned a tank. I was a tank driver and a cleaner, and my office was tank. Now whenever I had to go to garages to my tank, I had to cross a rivulet, which was mostly dry, a seasonal rivulet. But in monsoons when it was pouring, I had to go there. And jawans and rookies like me had to go through that rivulet. I saw Risaldar Sakat Singh cycling to garages. So I asked him, what is the correct way? He pointed towards the rivulet. When I reached the garages, I asked him. He was bone dry, I was dripping wet. I said, why didn't you show me the correct way? He said, but I showed you the correct path. Because of bad relations with neighboring unit, the route which is proper one to the garages has been made out of bound for jawans and people like you. When you grow up in rank, when you become a general, learn to manage the environment, have good relationships, and that is the correct way. He taught me this. He made me the soldier's general. We teach in IMA at the last step, which is called Antim Pag, safety, honor, and welfare of men you command comes first and always. Your own ease, comfort, and welfare comes last, always and every time. When you build your teams, think of it. Don't let the imaginary anchors weigh you down. Think of the Shaheen factor. There is a sher which says, Tu Shaheen hai, parwaz hai fitrat teri. Tere aage aasma aur bhi hai, imtaha aur bhi hai. You are the falcon and soaring is your nature. New horizons and new examinations and trials await you. But what is life without challenge? So learn to seek challenge. You have to take responsibility. You have to be proactive. I say responsibility has to be grabbed like this. When I was in peacekeeping mission in United Nations, we had armed forces people from 50 odd countries and civilians from about 100. And one day, next to our camp, one ammunition dump blew, and there were debris and shrapnels flying. The top leadership ran away to respective embassies. I was chief of operations. I was just a major. Top leadership was general. I took the challenge, and I took the charge. And you know what happened? After that crisis, for rest of my tenure, everybody used to consult me. I was the most popular guy. So if you grab the opportunity, your span of control, your influence will only grow. You have to learn the art of time management. You have to guard against urgency syndrome. You have to give quality time for self-development, upskilling yourself. Meditation, yoga for stress management. Invest in yourself. Today you hear of burnout syndrome. It's all because you refuse to spend quality time on yourself. That is may not be urgent, but it is important. As you will grow up, you will keep getting isolated. Very few people will tell you the truth, but you need to get the feedback. You have to open the channels. Kabir has said something very interesting. Nindak neere rakhiye, aangan kuti chhavai. bin sabun pani ke nirmal kare subhai. Keep your critics close. If possible, make a cottage for them in your own courtyard. Listen to them. Learn to listen, learn to empathize. It is an art. As you'll become senior leaders, you have to have this. We start all our activity by remembering Lord Ganesha. But what does Ganesha convey? Long ears, long trunk, sensors. Deploy your sensors. Seek domain awareness. Narrow mouth, speak less, meaningfully. And big belly, store data, information. This is the age of information. You will ride this wave if you have domain awareness, if you have awareness. Teams win matches. You all watched World Cup soccer. And what happened there? There was Messi from Argentina. There was Ronaldo from Portugal. There was Neymar from Brazil. Superstars. But did their team reach even the final rounds? Who reached finals? France and lowly Croatia. And the only superstar in Croatia, Nikola Kalinic, the AC Milan so-called super striker, showed his ego and he was fired and sent back. So without a superstar, Croatia was there. Second, so people are at heart of everything. Learn to subsume your identity within the team. You must learn the art of handling shifting goalposts. There is this thing which we hear on campus. Haath mein liye kitab, sari umar dhoondta raha sawalon ke jawab. Jindagi bhi ajeeb hai, and you can substitute this with examiner. Examiner bhi ajeeb hai, har baar syllabus se bahar se hi poochta hai sawal. So this will happen to you. You will set your compass. There'll be goalposts, but they will shift. That doesn't mean you don't set the compass. But you must be aware of that. And Chinese have a beautiful way to write crisis. When they write crisis in Chinese, the character, first one is danger, and second one is opportunity. You have to choose whether you'll get bogged down in danger or you will grab the opportunity. That is your choice. And they incidentally call it Wai Chi. You must, as you grow up and go in senior leadership, you must learn the art of delegation. We tend to centralize power within ourselves. I handled Pathankot attack on that airbase. Now, there were, when I went there, there was a commander-in-chief, two DGPs, one additional DGP, all huddled in one crisis management room, trying to confuse the real crisis manager. I had to push them out. I had to tell them, go away. Organize that place. If you are controlling a crisis at higher level, you don't have to be inside that crisis. You have to be outside and retain your span of control. After all, those people had bigger responsibilities. And you must learn to take calculated risks. You must push the envelope. Try and make the impossible possible. You may be surprised, because I have experimented with this many times. I was making a museum. I had to put an old engine and a coach. Everybody told me, can't happen. Need huge big money, logistics. But we did it. It is possible. So impossible may be, I am possible. You have to navigate through milestones. And when you do that, you must discover your mojo, your USP, your legacy, and build it. And stick to values. There'll be too many temptations, but learn to ride through them. And discover humor, your funny bone. Be childlike also, and enjoy the journey. I would tell you that never lose your smile. Sit easy in saddle of life. And you all have seen Three Idiots or heard about this movie. My recommendation is try and become the fourth idiot. Enjoy the journey. Now, as I finish, I must tell you that my first tank, ZX-1685, was my first love. And the day I was retiring, I got the biggest surprise. My buddies, my colleagues, my soldiers, they found that tank, which was still in service, refurbished it. And the last thing in the army that happens is that you are suddenly ceremonially pulled out in a vehicle. It may be Jeep, it can be Jonga. But they pulled me out in my first tank, 1685. That is my legacy, being the soldier's general. That is the love and affection which brings people to do such wonderful things for you. And the very last thing that I want to tell you is, in TEDx talks, you're not allowed to ask a question. But if I was to enter your mind and guess the question that you want to ask me is, that many of you will want to ask me, sir, should we all join army? Should we all try and become generals? No, please don't do it. After class 12, I qualified in three things. NDA, T.S. Dufferin, which is now called Rajendra for Merchant Navy, and also BITS Pilani. But I chose NDA. So you can make your choices. All of you don't have to join army in any case. Remember, today, due to hybrid war, the war has come to your doorsteps. You will remember Makkah Masjid blast here in Hyderabad. Terrorists can come anywhere. The need for us is to be citizen warriors, what I call as Jagruk Hindustani, the soldier who guards our borders. He is lonely. He suffers privation. He faces danger. But he will feel very proud, very determined, when he knows that he is guarding the citizen warriors, the Jagruk Hindustani. Can I ask you one question at least, that to become a Jagruk Hindustani, how is the Josh? That answer is not good. How is the Josh? Thank you. Jai Hind.